Welcome to our channel Sparkles College, and this is Sadaf Meher. Today we'll be discussing about the business organization, which is very first topic of paper F1, accountant in business. But before moving ahead, let me tell you something about our channel and the motive behind creating this channel. We have created this channel for students who cannot attend proper ACCA classes in some institutes. So to make ACCA lectures accessible for such students, we have created this channel. So like our videos, subscribe to our channel and share it with your friends. Now coming back to the topic, we'll be discussing about organization. What is an organization? Now, there are many type of organizations which are set up to cater different needs of different group of people in society. For example, schools set up to provide education, hospitals set up to provide medical treatments, clubs for recreational activities. Now, how to define an organization? Due to different types and characteristics of organizations, it is difficult to have any specific definition of organizations. But all organizations have some common grounds on which they are set up. This is summarized in definition given by Buchanan and Hukansky, which explains, organizations are social arrangements for the controlled performance of collective goals. Now we will discuss the basic aspects of definition. First of all, collective goals. Generally, organizations are defined by their goals and are organized accordingly. For example, a goal of a charity organization is to provide relief and to work for welfare of underprivileged section of society. So it is organized differently to a company that has goal to maximize profits. Social arrangements. Organizations are set up where people are allowed to work towards achieving common goal. A single person working to achieve a certain goal cannot be defined as an organization. As far as structures are concerned, the larger the organization, the more formal its structure. Controlled performance. To achieve its goals, an organization will have systems and procedures that contribute towards achieving its goals. For example, an organization that aims to maximize profits will set systems and procedures to set sales targets or to assess staff performance on an annual basis. Now, what is the key similarity amongst organizations? That is, every organization takes input and transforms it into output. For example, a manufacturing company will have input, raw material, output, finished products ready to deliver to customers. In the same way, an IT training firm will have input, students, and the output will be IT programmers and professionals. Now we will discuss why do we need organizations? Why organizations are needed? Organizations enable sharing of knowledge and skills. In an organization, group of people work towards achieving common goal, which they cannot achieve on their own if working individually. They learn new skills and also knowledge is shared within an organization. Specialization. Individual workers can concentrate on certain type of work that will help them to build up greater level of skills and knowledge. For example, an ACCA qualified will be assigned accountancy task or activity. An MBA marketing will be given marketing activity. Pool resources. It can be money or time. Now, the result of having organizations. Because of all three factors that I discussed earlier, an organization can achieve more rather than the individuals working on their own. And this phenomenon is known as synergy. So this is all for today's lecture. Thank you for watching our video. Stay tuned for more and like, share and subscribe our channel.